The Mapogos had never had to take down large prey on their own. Making a kill would be their first challenge of survival. Over the next few months, the Mapogos would keep honing their hunting skills, trying to build on their confidence taking large prey. But even with a coalition of six lions, it was going to take time. Often they became opportunists, scavenging at carcasses wherever they could. Sometimes bullying females aside so they could quickly eat their fill. But with ever-watchful dominant males around, this led to the Mapogos having some narrow escapes. Eventually, the young Mapogos became the big game hunters they were destined to be. Buffalo were targeted most. But they also took down hippo. Young rhino. And like their fathers before them, they even killed giraffe.
What was quite unique about them, when they were hunting, they would move together as a group.
Kick your tail just like a fox terrier. You know, he was game for anything.
He was more like the brute. He did a lot of the legwork. Makula Mapogo would often be the one that worked out where to go and would be the first one to loop around to like almost direct the show. And then Kinkytail was the one who did the brute work of the attack, so grab on a buffalo.
Mr. T and Kinkytail were always in the middle of everything. They were always a little more aggressive in the actual kill.
The fact that these males learned how to hunt buffalo really was the key to their success, because they all grew to be big and strong.